Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, retired senior lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity. So my Christianity is very scientific, and I haven't been to any theological colleges or universities. So it's a basic knowledge, and which you best learn from people who can think themselves. And here it is, you know, in the first part, I described heaven and kingdom of heaven, which is outside in this world. So what applies to flesh opposite to spirits? So the royal kingdom of God is within our hearts. And in this part, it is about the royal kingdom of God, because that's the only kingdom that exists in this dark age. The kingdom of heaven is nowhere to be seen or come into contact or to be observed. Thus, Sachae Paatshah. Sachae Paatshah means, Sachae means the true, Paatshah means who is a royal king. Thus, Sachae Paatshah, Har Gobind Ji, the first, the founder of Khalsa Panth, was put on a Khanda. Khanda is the double-edged sword of his word, the double-edged sword in the name of Har. Har means God, and a sword in the name of Gobind. So he had two things put on him during his initiation ceremony. One was a Khanda, which was put from right, from left to right, from left shoulder to right hand side. The sword was put from right to left. That means when you ply sword, you keep it in mind, the double-edged sword of his word. So the Akaal Takht is the, in Amritsar, Akaal mean eternal God, and his Takht mean his throne. The Akaal Takht was built by Sachae Paatshah Har Gobind Ji for the apostles to render the exposition of BAANI. BAANI mean his word, and to resolve the religious issues among the, any religious issue people had, they will go to the Akaal Takht and they will solve their problem, resolve it. This holiest of holy complex was meant for the Sikhs, the Bhagat. The Bhagats mean those who don't take to sword but use the word power, Khanda of his word, the double-edged sword of his word. They are called Bhagats. They don't fight, they don't take to sword. Like Bhai Ghaniaya. Bhai Ghaniaya was a Sikh, you know, of Satguru Nanak Dev Ji, who was serving water to the people who were fighting and killing each other. While the Khalsa was doing their job, he was doing his job. And the apostles like Bhai Buddha Ji. Bhai Buddha was one of the great apostles, expositor of his word. So it was his seat like that. But today it is in the grips of Mammon worshippers, whose table Jesus turned down in his father's house, meant for spiritual devotion, gospel, leads an individual to peace of mind called ANAND PUR SAHIB in Punjabi and bliss in English. So Jesus turned this temple, which is in Amritsar, which is called Golden Temple, is the replacement of the Jerusalem Temple. In Jerusalem Temple, Jesus turned their tables and pushed them out. But here, the Mammon worshippers have a strong grip, and they have put gold on top of the dome to attract the simple-minded people for fleecing. As it is that after having learned about Akaal Purakh, God, that you want to serve him and him alone, the name of the town where Sachae Paatshah Gobind Singh Ji, Gobind Singh Ji was the last prophet on earth. There were four prophets, two in the Middle East, two in the East. So he was the last on the earth. Crowned the Khalsa, Khalsa being Puritans, to become independent, needing no more guidance from any, is called ANAND PUR SAHIB. ANAND PUR means a town of bliss. That is the town lived by those who have the knowledge of Akaal Purakh, God. Royal King Gobind Singh Ji used to hold court like other kings, you know, secular kings. He used to also have his, used to hold spiritual court, in which songs in the praise of Akaal Purakh, God, and ballads in the names of his warriors who fought against the sons of Satan to uphold his will were sung. Now the word of God is called SATT in Punjabi. SATT means gospel truth, and not SACH. SACH means secular truth, what people speak. SATT is absolute truth, which is non-retractable, while SACH is, while the SACH is retractable, and it could be, it is what you see with your two naked eye, but SATT is the absolute truth. This will need some explanation. People say Sikhs, Hindus, Jews, etc. are born and they also died. Such statements are such. That means secular truth. It's not spiritual gospel truth for the once born people, but they are not SATT, gospel truth, for the twice born people, as religious selves being of the heart. We call it NAADI ROOP. NAADI mean what comes out of your mouth, and not of the flesh, BINDI ROOP. BINDI ROOP mean which is born of a seed of certain person, of family, tribal link, were never born and they never die. So spiritual selves are never born and they never die. Such statements are false, KOFIR, or KOORR, and they are subject to correction in the light of gospel. So these people who speak that the Sikhs, Jews, Muslims, Hindus died, you know, so they make incorrect or speak falsehoods, which we call KUFIR or KOORR in Punjabi. So these statements, they are in the light of gospel truth, that is, they are retractable. That means they are wrong, you know. So they are not true. Not a single Sikh died, not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, because they are spiritual selves, but people did die. They were not the spiritual selves, but the tribal self. SATT is the tribal. SATT is that the tribal people are born and the tribal people die. So in the court of Sachae Paatshah Gobind Singh Ji, nobody spoke falsehoods, KUFIR or KOORR, and people enjoyed the bliss of speaking SATT, gospel truth. That created a gap, the divine love among the people of different tribes. In a nutshell, this dark age is not of heaven and hell, but of the peace of mind in gospel, called ANAND, or bliss, enjoyed by an individual. So this gospel is learnt, or is a, by the grace of God you get it, and when you get it, it's for your enjoyment, and you enjoy it, it's for your intrinsic enjoyment, and it has a, you preach to other people and you don't impose it, because it's always received by grace. Whosoever is a, get the grace of God will get it. This dark age is of the SATT, of gospel truth, and not of the SACH, secular truth, as it is further emphasized in the puzzle. We have in Indian language puzzle is thal vich tin vastu payo SATT SANTOKH VICHARO. Vicharo means find out. The, it means that in a plate there are three things that you want to eat, which is SATT, gospel truth, SANTOKH is contentment, and Vicharo means ponder over. Ponder the is